Hey guys, with winter holidays right around the corner, no celebration is complete without plants, greenery, and basically that whole evergreen vibe. So really, it should come as no surprise that the Norfolk pine has really become kind of a pseudo Christmas tree, or which some refer to as the living Christmas tree. I've personally never adorned mine with ornaments, but I can totally see why some people totally do it. Although I nearly shit my pants when I heard that people throw out or discard their Norfolk pine after the holiday season. Not cool. I got mine on sale after the holiday season last holidays, so I've had this guy for about a year, and there is an opportunity in there for those savvy shoppers. Either way, I'm here to change your mind and share with you guys and really explain how these are the perfect houseplant all year round. So, full disclosure, I do keep mine as an indoor-outdoor plant. It's indoors during the winter, and I keep this on my back deck over the summer season. Now, this whole indoor-outdoor setup really works for me. You can keep your Norfolk pine indoors all year round. Just make sure to pay special attention to the lighting requirements. All right, so the Norfolk pine is a beautiful plant. Definitely a beautiful house plant, and I'm going to be sharing all of the crucial care tips that you need to know, as well as some key considerations for caring for these plants. But as well, I'm going to be doing a little bit of a troubleshooting guide if you are having any sort of browning, yellowing, or dropping foliage. I'm going to explain why that may be and what you can do to remedy those problems. So if you're interested in all of that, plus a little bit more, stay tuned. Thanks for checking out this video. I'm Tyler, and if you like what you're seeing or you find this video to be useful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, or better yet, you can subscribe to my channel. So first things first, let's jump right into those crucial care tips. In terms of lighting, you're gonna want to give your Norfolk pine as much light as you possibly can. Especially if this is a full-time indoor plant, you're really going to wanna make sure it's getting a ton of light. Now, if you are transitioning your Norfolk pine indoors, outdoors, and vice versa, like I do, then these plants are able to tolerate a little bit less light over winter and when you do bring it indoors, but that's really only the case if you are transitioning them throughout these two seasons. Now, as far as watering is concerned, you are going to want to water your Norfolk pine when the topsoil is dry to the touch. Now, this may be weekly, this may be once every 2 weeks. It's really dependent on the conditions and those other conditions that your Norfolk pine is receiving. Soil composition is key for the Norfolk pine. Now, for mine, I've used a sort of gritty, chunky, and slightly acidic soil mix. Now, I have gone ahead and used basically some peat moss in combination with a cactus or succulent mix, and this is really doing the trick. Now, humidity is key for the Norfolk pine. It's super, super important, and it's something that you definitely need to be considering, especially during those winter months when it's dry AF. In terms of fertilizer, a well-diluted liquid fertilizer is a great place to start during the growing season. And here are a couple of other things to keep in mind before jumping into those troubleshooting details. You're only going to want to repot your Norfolk pine when you're absolutely sure that this thing is root-bound. In other words, you're seeing roots come out from the bottom of the container, or you know, it's overflowing something. It's not a plant that needs to be repotted very often, so you definitely want to make sure that it's root bound before doing so. Spring is the best time to repot your Norfolk pine. And I'm not sure if I mentioned this, but the reason that we keep these plants indoors over winter is because they are not great at handling cooler temperatures, so that's why these definitely need to be indoors over the winter season. All right, so yellow, brown, or dropping foliage is not uncommon. Let me break down for you guys why your Norfolk pine may be experiencing some of these things. But first, if you are interested in more content like this, don't hesitate to leave a comment down below or give this video a thumbs up. And to really show me some love, consider hitting the bell for alerts and notifications for future content. All right, so let's first start with browning foliage. One of the reasons you could be, your Norfolk pine could be experiencing browning foliage could be due to fluctuating temperatures. So if you've left it outdoors, for example, rather late and it's sort of experiencing a fluctuation in temperatures, that could cause the foliage to brown. Browning foliage could be the result of under or over watering as well. So a little bit of thinking to do if you have some brown foliage. Now, next, if you are experiencing some yellowing on your Norfolk pine, this is basically probably caused from either too much or too little light. So you may need to move your Norfolk pine to a different spot or kind of rethink its lighting condition. Finally, if your Norfolk pine is dropping some of its foliage, this could be a result of overwatering your plant, or it's basically just not receiving enough light. So it's a pretty serious indication, actually, that it might be time to reconsider where you have it or how you're caring for your Norfolk pine. All right, so hopefully this little guide is helpful for you guys if you are experiencing some issues with your Norfolk pine, but definitely don't throw it out. Well, that's it for me. Oh yeah, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Miss you guys already. Until the next one.